I've been, you know, just sort of putting off making a video because I've been enjoying my vacation, I've been enjoying my spare time, I've been playing a lot of video games, but I was like really okay. I was saying to myself, it's July, you know, the summer is like, what? Like, we're about halfway through hiatus, they're gonna start filming soon, it's time to get back into making videos, and I was really gonna do it, and then, guess what happened? Cote de Pablo is not re-signing with NCIS. She'll be back for an undetermined amount of episodes and just to wrap up her character, but she's not going to come back. It is the end of Tiva, it is the end of Ziva, and it's very depressing. Like, I'm not as broken up as a lot of people. My heart does go out to those people, I think especially for Tiva reasons, because I know a lot of people are upset, and I really get it, because I think if it had been a couple years ago, I would have been absolutely inconsolable. So I really feel for us as a fandom, because this really sucks. I plan to do sort of a fuller video about this, because this is just completely just because I felt like I should put up something, but I want to do something maybe a little bit more put together. But yeah. Just initial reaction, I guess, is just hopeful that we'll get a good send-off. So yeah, first stage, I guess, of hearing it was probably just hope that I was okay. Mainly she's coming back to wrap up, because like that's happened with other shows that I watched, that somebody has not re-signed and then just doesn't come back at all, and that really sucks. But thankfully, you know, she is going to come back for a couple episodes. They're going to be able to wrap up her character, and hopefully she will not be killed off. So I guess I'm just hoping that, you know, she'll leave the show, but that maybe it'll leave the opportunity for her to come back, or that they just won't brutally kill her off. Yeah, my second stage is definitely anger. Not really at Cody. Like, I don't feel like I blame Cody. I feel like something, I mean, I don't know what happened, but I feel like it was something with negotiations and maybe her not getting what she deserved. Yeah, that's my gut. That's what my gut's telling me, but I don't really know for sure. And but yeah, I guess I'm just sort of angry from a Tiva standpoint, because like I'm kind of in the Tiva mindset where like I shipped Tiva for years, and like I made fan videos and I made endless amounts of art, and I read fan fiction and I wrote fan fiction about them, and I loved them, and that kind of faded away within the last couple of years, because I feel like it dragged on and on, and as much as I still enjoyed watching it, I just wasn't really as invested, and I guess that's kind of saved me a lot of heartache, because I gradually grew away from absolute obsession, and now I'm just kind of disappointed, because I feel like, you know, we have been robbed, because they put it off for 8 years, and I guess that this is what happens when you put that off for 8 years, and now they've got it. If they do end up doing anything, they've got to rush it in like a couple episodes, and then it's just gonna end. So it really sucks for us, because that's what happens. You're putting it off and putting it off and putting it off, and you know, you can, I mean, people that work on the show, I don't think you're ever gonna watch this, but I mean, certain people that have made comments can say whatever they want. I mean, you look back in the past, it's like, oh, it's coming, you know, we're getting there, you know, we're just working towards a place, and that's all well and good, but I mean, in my opinion, what it came down to was fear, and they were afraid of it going wrong, and they were afraid of people losing interest, and they wanted to put it off until like the last possible moment, and unfortunately that kind of blew up in their face. And now Cody's not coming back. You know, wish her the best of luck. Nothing against her personally. And, but this is gonna make it really hard for me to enjoy season 11. And, I don't know. I don't feel very, I mean, I guess I'm kind of feeling what a lot of people are, is that I don't know if the show's gonna be the same. I'm not gonna really sure. I'm not really sure I'm going to be as invested in the show, as I was before, and it's kind of, I mean, I guess, you know, to be perfectly honest, I've been kind of on a downhill slope for a while with the show. As much as I love it, I'm sort of no longer obsessed with it, and this is definitely not helping. This is not helping my motivation to get excited about the show and make videos about the show when just stuff like this is going on, so it really sucks. And yeah. Guess that's it. Hopefully I will make a video that's a little bit more full of my predictions and speculations, but this for now, this is it. Leave your comments and whatever in the description and we shall mourn together, and I don't care how many like happy, fluffy, it's gonna be okay tweets happen, because this fandom is in mourning. I'm wearing black, I'm wearing some Cody inspired earrings, and I'm just gonna get through this. Anyway, what can you do? Can you name the most popular TV show in America? You guessed NCIS, you're right. If you're a longtime fan of the show, or maybe you're just getting started, sit down with us as we analyze every case, every ship, and every head slap from the latest episode. You'll also be sure to meet your daily quota of news, spoilers, videos, and cats. That's right, Sansa.
Tuesday, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific at live.ncisfanatic.com.